and welcome to Secrets of the Sega CD Part 2. If you're new to this video series and watching for the first time, I seriously recommend you watch Part 1 first. So what is 2M mode? In 2M mode, all 256 kilobytes of word RAM are accessible by the Mega Drive or CD at any one time. And as with 1M mode, a flag is used to decide which system has access to the word RAM. The ASICs can only access the word RAM when the flag is set to the CD. Like with 1M mode, program RAM can only be accessed by the Mega Drive when the CD's CPU is halted. So let's get on to talking about the ASICs. The ASICs has a number of functions. In this video, I'll talk about the coordinate conversion function. When using the function, the ASIC splits the word RAM into an output bitmap, stamps, and a stamp map. The ASIC draws to the stamp map, and this is then converted into an output bitmap. Hardware inside the CD then enables the Mega Drive VDP to read the bitmap as standard 8x8 tiles. The ASIC's output bitmap is similar to that of the 32x's frame buffer, but there are a couple of key differences. Firstly, the output bitmap is comprised of a palette of 16 colours, compared to the 32x's frame buffer of 32,768. Secondly, is that the bitmap is read by the Mega Drive's VDP as a group of tiles arranged in a specific format. These are then displayed by the Mega Drive's sprite or background planes. The 32x, on the other hand, has its own dedicated plane to display graphics. So how could we use the ASIC's scaling for 3D? Early fake 3D games such as Wolf 3D and Doom don't use polygon texture mapping. They instead use a technique called lines of constant Z. These are lines that have identical Z values and so must be straight and at right angles to the camera, hence the straight walls, floors and ceilings you'll find in these games. The ASICs is capable of handling lines of constant Z via the coordinate conversion function. So in theory, these should be able to be rendered by the ASICs. So we know the CD can render Raycast. Let's do Doom! Unfortunately, there are some issues with this idea. While the CD has the grunt to render the environment, consoles like the Atari Jaguar and the 32X had the CPU power to calculate the BSP trees. For the CD CPU to cope with the level of geometry, we would need to simplify the environments. This could be achieved by removing processor-intensive elements such as variable ceiling heights and room features such as columns. But it's worth noting that even Doom on the 32X had to alter layouts to enable the 32X to cope. Unfortunately, that's not the only issue the CD has to cope with. The slow CD-ROM drive and lack of RAM are also problematic. Doom assumes a minimum of 2 megabytes of RAM for graphics and sound, and when needed loads further graphics to memory from disk on the fly. Doom's levels tend to be designed around the max buffer size of the game's original code, which was 6 megabytes of RAM. Wolf 3D has lower requirements but still assumes between 1 and 2 megabytes of RAM. This is where the Sega 32X had an advantage. Cart-based versions of both Wolf 3D and Doom are able to use cart space to store graphics. Both Chilly Willy's port of Wolf 3D and the 32X version of Doom do this to overcome the 32X's lack of RAM. For the CD to do the same, it would need to cache graphics in a section of the 256 kilobytes of word RAM. This could be done, though some drastic modifications to levels would be required, so that fewer textures were used and everything could fit nicely into the word RAM. Alternatively, the game could make the user wait every time a new texture needed to be loaded from the CD drive. This is not something anyone would particularly want. Remember, the CD drive is only one speed. There is another solution to this issue, and that is the use of a RAM card in the Mega Drive. A 4 meg RAM card was developed for the CD by Tido many years back. The card can plug into the Mega Drive and be used in conjunction with the CD. To use the card effectively, level data would first need to be loaded to the RAM card from the CD. During a level, if the CD required new textures to render a scene, it could flip the word RAM to the Mega Drive and send the Mega Drive a command to copy the data from the RAM card to the word RAM. Once this transfer was completed, the Mega Drive could then flip the the word RAM back to the CD. This would be relatively quick, as copying small amounts of data across the bus of the two machines is fairly fast. So without the need for additional hardware and minimal alteration to the level geometry, what could we aim for? A good in-between game that's not quite Doom, but more advanced than Wolf 3D, would be Blake's Stone. So how would that work? Well, we'll talk about that in part 3. I don't generally speak through this bit, but I'm going to on this occasion. I'd like to thank all my patrons, everyone who's waited ages for this video, I must apologise, Joseph Fenton for all the info for this video, without him validating everything I don't know what I'd do, Tito for his information on the RAM cart, maybe this video will lead to more interest in it, who knows, and we'll leave it there. See ya!